This, well, okay. First of all, welcome back to Gardening with Ryan. Today's a very special episode because look what we have now. First time using this thing. This rinse, shrub, clean, soft wash, jet, flower, sweep, garden. Oh, we're gardening, so garden, of course. Oh, wow. That's nice. Let me just... Anyway, in this episode, we are going to be ranting about operating systems and why they're all terrible right now. Same. I'm a pretty simple man when it comes to computers. And what I want in an operating system is... Now, when I say simple to use, I don't mean like... normie friendly, don't touch a command line, whatever. I'm just saying. Okay, I'll get right to it. I want something that's not full of bloat, is usable, is not literally like a job to maintain, and is stable. Now, let's go through the different candidates and why they all suck. First, we'll go to Windows 10 because Windows 10 recently pissed me off. That new Jade plant is still all, like, hungover from the transplant. That's okay. Just gonna water these a bit, because these look a little withered. But anyway, recently, on my desktop, a Windows update was rolled out that, to keep a long story short, actually made my Windows install unrecoverable. Somehow, some way, it made it so that I could not even access the administrator account of the user or get a Windows command line going. And this all started with installing a screwy graphics driver or something. I don't really know the details, but Microsoft acknowledged that their update broke lots of things. So, now on the Windows 10 download page, it says, hey, make sure your hard drive isn't on the list of things that'll totally get screwed. Now, a couple days after this event, on my work PC, which is a Mac that I boot camped into Windows to run Linux on. I know, sounds whack, right? But VirtualBox was giving me issues on Windows and on Mac, I mean. And I was like, man, I don't want to figure this out. So, I installed Windows through boot camp so I could run Linux. And, you know, Windows update kicked in after the second day of it being installed and broke the graphics driver. But I guess by this point, Microsoft had already realized how much they screwed up and put some sort of, like, fail-safe in there to say, like, hey, undo this thing. Let's go for, let's go for sweep. I wonder what that looks like. Oh, wow. Perfect. But anyway, enough about Windows. Most of the people on this video probably already know Windows sucks. Whatever. Always has. Well, not always. Windows 7 was fine. You didn't have to deal with this crap. Windows 8 didn't even... You know, I actually... This is really controversial, but my favorite version of Windows ever was Windows 8. Because, you know what, it had that previous versions of Windows didn't, that I came to just accept as being part of the Linux kernel, so I guess I got used to it. Automatic drivers! You could throw together a PC and then connect to the internet and have a resolution bigger than 800 by 600. Like, out of the box! And then it would go download the rest, even if just a basic version. But it was pre all the Windows 10 crap. Anyway, then it's like, all right, fine, I'll use Linux. Well, first of all, the only reason I'm running Windows on anything is because Discord, and I do a lot of stuff with Discord, will only capture audio from a Windows audio driver, and now they have a Mac application, and hey, I know if you have that Mac application, you can make it into the Linux one pretty easily, man. It was the same hurdle either way. I mean, it's a Unix system. I mean, Mac OS can't be that different from the free BSD that it descends from, right? Like, come on now. Give us audio capture in Linux now. Please, Discord. Please. But anyway, so we say, okay, Windows is trash, let's go to Linux. Well, first of all, Canonical and Microsoft are, like, BFFLs now, and when you go to try to install Ubuntu first, it's like, wait, but did you know that you can, like, you don't actually need to do this? You can... Oh, that's powerful. This is too much power for one man to wield. Shrub. Whoa, what the heck? Clean. That's nice. But... basically, you go to Linux and Ubuntu's trash. Because there's... so much crap on there you don't want. You install it and it asks you to sign in to a bunch of crap. It asks you if you would like to submit anonymous data or whatever. It tries to sign you in, and then it's like, oh, you can live patch if you sign in. You can this, connect your Microsoft account. And it's like, this is exactly the reason I installed something that wasn't Windows. And there's all these processes going that you don't know anything about. You're like, ooh, flower. That's an interesting list. But there's all this software that you don't use, like, you will never care about, but you're kind of stuck with. And it's just, there's so much bloat and crap and stuff you don't understand. I mean, I think Ubuntu is one of the hardest to use distributions, because just to understand all the underlying stuff going on, and don't even get me started on all these stupid new package management systems. They're like, you know what? The way we've been handling dependencies forever does not work, but let's try to mix the traditional way with a new way in snap. You know, I like Flatpak or whatever. You know, actually, I don't really get it. I feel like we actually did fine before any of these Dockers or snaps or Flatpaks. Like, I feel like we managed. Right? But, so it's like, okay, well, Ubuntu's trash. Well, what about Mama Debian? Man, I like Debian, but those packages are so old, and then you can run testing or unstable or SID, but then it's just, then you don't have the stability, and you have to check every upgrade you make, and you gotta make sure you don't break dependencies, and you gotta make sure that if you're using it for work, it's not gonna crap out on you, which at least you can count on Ubuntu for. Now, some people, now it's like, alright, we gotta get advanced. And then you get into the dweeb distros, like Gentoo and Arch and stuff, and those are really, really fun to play with, don't get me wrong, they really are. They really are a good time, but when you are counting on that thing powering up and your documents staying on there, the closest thing that I have tried in recent times to a Linux distro I really liked was Solus, but the problem there is that not enough people use it. Because you've got like the BSDs and stuff and all that, but you end up just using a bunch of Linux ports, right? You've got like the RPM and the dead packages for Linux usually, and if you're on BSD, you're using a bunch of Linux ports. Even if you're on Windows, I like to see Linux growing, and I guess I shouldn't be too surprised that it's seeing a lot of commercial use, but where's our dweeb hobby distro that we can also depend on? Like, Ubuntu and, like, Debian. Okay, here's the thing. Linux isn't as cool anymore. We want a cool distro that isn't for scrubs. You know, and when I say scrub, I say it jokingly. I'm like, we want something that makes us feel like we're in a hacker movie. We all know it's true. That isn't filled with corporate crap. That also doesn't spy on us. And you know what? I installed OpenBSD in a VM. And honestly, it was fantastic. It was so easy to use. You would think the exact opposite, right? You would think, okay, and it only gives you a command line installation, and you start, and your root shell, if I believe, this was a couple months ago, but I think you're in, like, the corn shell or something. So you'd be like, but no, it was so easy to use. The documentation of that operating system is about as close to perfect. I haven't tried FreeBSD yet, but so that was really comfy, but I realized I can't just count on this. It's some obscure, the reason, did I say I installed OpenBSD? Because that's when I saw it. I'm like, the reason this is so secure is because no one uses it. So, Linux dweebs of the world, please start using something that is, you know, it would just be glorious. Like, Windows 10, Microsoft kind of did Windows 10 well, in the sense of, okay, it's like rolling release, but it keeps working, but stays current. Now, I know there's, I don't want to give too much credit, but something like Solus, you know, something intended for home computing. But my grievance with Solus is no server version, no intent to provide server version. Come on, man. Every desk, every Linux, no one can do everything, but like, I guess they're not really harming anyone by not providing a server version. Just install what you want if you want to run it as a server. I guess if you know how to run a server, you don't really need it provided as a server version. But if anything, this video convinced me to go try some less popular distro like Solus or something, or like Void maybe, or I don't know. Just something obscure, but man, you know why I don't want to use Arch? Because it's, see, I've only used Manjaro like once, and I've never installed Arch, but like, why? I get it if OSs are purely a hobby, right? Like, if a system breaking is not, like, the end of the world. Or maybe you guys are just way better than I am at administrating systems. Because you know what I'm running on the server that, you know, I need to keep running. Like, you know what I run on the server that I actually need to maintain? Ubuntu LTS, whatever version they have, because you know what? It's probably gonna still work. And, you know, I could go try Linux Mint again and, like, since they don't like snaps, I don't think, but, like, I'm pretty sure. See, I also, I would really like an OS that does not have a political philosophy underlying it. Like, I like free software, but I'm not, like, morally committed to it as, like, an ethical principle. I'm much more inclined towards, like, the BSD type of licenses rather than the... It's free, but... You better keep it free, buddy. So... I don't want to accidentally compile something that I have to keep free, and then I forgot to put, like, the GPL in there or something, and then I go to jail. It doesn't really sound like freedom. Anyway. Thanks for joining me on this episode. And... see you all on whatever I make next.